Hi guys and welcome back. This is going to be an absolutely fantastic, fabulous episode. You know why? Because I'm going to talk to you about a topic that's really close to my heart, and I absolutely love telling people of this kind of marketing and communications. Yes, we are going to talk about hospitality, marketing and communications, an industry I've been a part of for a long time and I absolutely adore. Now, you must remember, when it comes to hotels, this is one industry that runs 365 days a year, 366 days a year, 24/7. So when it comes to selling a product like this, how do you make a communications campaign that's evocative, that has emotions, that has feelings, and yet delivers a kick-ass experience? Yes, this is one of the few products where probably you end up buying it much before you actually enter the guest rooms or much before you actually enter the hotel space. So let's get started. What is it that a hotel actually has to sell? Yes, of course, we have beautiful grand rooms. We have the finest F&B outlets. F&B is food and beverage. We have wellness. We have lifestyle. We have these beautiful grand banqueting spaces which are best for weddings, conferences, events, incentives, name it and you get it. So in a combination of this, what is critical to hospitality marketing is your location. Your location determines exactly where you position your hotel and how you write a marketing and communications campaign that is really, really relevant for your audience. For example, if you have a small boutique hotel that's maybe in a leisure destination, you might want to position it as a wedding space, you might want to position it as a wellness getaway. Same thing, probably in a city which is more of a business traveler, you might want to position the hotel as the place for the business consumers. In that kind of a space, your marketing communications campaign will vastly differ. To reiterate, there are a couple of elements that stay consistent regardless of whichever hotel it is. Number one, your rooms. Number two, your food and beverage. Number three, your banqueting and conference spaces. Number four, your wellness and lifestyle options. Every hotel has a few components that stay consistent and constant. The rooms, the food and beverage or the dining options that we talk about, the wellness and lifestyle options that we talk about, say it a gym, a spa, a pool. And finally, we come to the banqueting and conferencing space that is a constant in all hotels. If you have a large banqueting space, probably you will want to position your hotel as perfect for weddings and events. If, however, rooms is something that is more of your USP, you want to position that perfectly for a business traveler. What is it that you need to know more about hospitality marketing? Every time you create a hospitality content, please understand it has to do with lifestyle. The content has to be evocative. For an end user, whether it's a room, a dining outlet, a food and beverage option, a drink, a cocktail, a cup of tea, a great wedding, unless and until your end user feels something right here, they will not be able to come to your hotel. They will not be able to understand what it is that makes your hotel different from others. Is it the service that you're talking about? Is it the kind of decor that you're talking about? Is it the kind of food that you have? Is it the kind of menu that you have? Do you have a stunning location? What I really recommend is, next time you look at the hotel in terms of a living, breathing entity, something that is pulsating with life, something that has so much more, so that when you write your marketing and communications campaign for your brand of hotels, it really touches the audience's heart more often than not. Somebody who has never worked in hospitality, for them, some terms and some jargons are very, very critical to know. So the next time you probably walk into a hotel, talk to the team members, here are some terms that are mandatory. You will hear them, you'll see them, you'll come to know about them only and only if you work in hospitality. So let's get started on this. The first term that I want to talk about is MICE. Yes, M-I-C-E, MICE. For a hotelier, MICE represents a business segment. It's meetings, incentives, conferences and exhibitions, which is critical to hotels that have a large banqueting space. OTAs, yes, online travel agencies. OTAs are third-party websites on which the hotel actually sells its room and package inventory. So the next time you come to think of an OTA, you know what we are talking about. Another term, packs, for an end user when he or she says it's 200 number of guests, for a hotelier, they would probably say, oh, it's a 200 packs wedding, it's a 200 packs event. Yes, packs means number of guests. So now you know what we are talking about when we say X number of packs is coming to the hotel or X number of rooms are being sold. An FIT, a free independent traveler or a free individual traveler. A very, very lucrative segment for all hotels. Why? Because their average spends are much higher than people who are traveling in groups. So next time you hear of this, an FIT is coming, you know what you are referring to. GDS, a global distribution system, which is a large data network that assimilates your room rates and the room inventories to maximize your room revenue or the hotel revenue for that matter. So probably all and most hotels are listed on a GDS platform. Now let's look at CMS, a content management system, which is basically a tool or rather a platform to ensure that your hotel website content or your online content is always updated and gives your guests the latest room rates, the latest bookings, the latest offers, and the latest amount of information that you want to share. An APC, an ADR, and an ARR. APC is nothing more than an average per cover or average per customer, which is more related to your dining outlet for that matter. So if you want to calculate how much of revenue your restaurant can earn, you want to look at an APC for that matter. Your average daily rate and your average room rate are rates for which pertain to your room revenue. So the total number of revenue that you've received divided by the number of rooms sold gives you this particular figure. And the most critical component would be the big term. Yes, the GOP, the gross operating profit, which indicates the profitability or the operational profitability of a hotel. So next time you hear all these big terms, you can refer right to this episode and know what it is all about. To conclude this episode of My Marketing Mantras, I wanted to leave you with some trends that I feel will be big for 2020 hospitality marketing. The first one, green stays. Yes, how green is your hotel? How environment friendly are you are when you promote and talk about your hotel stay? So green stays are big for the future. You need to be environment friendly and environment conscious when you are giving a wonderful stay experience to your guests. Another big one, content marketing. Great content, great photography, great videos is what is going to attract your audience. So make sure that when you have a social media post going in, the content is spectacularly beautiful. Can you engage with your audience enough to drive footfalls? Why not? Great content always helps. And if you want to know more about what it is for 2020 that you need to be working out on, please follow the links here and know more. Stay tuned for the next episode.